I'm Fraser Kane, the publisher of Universe Today. Let's look close to home, in orbit around the planet at the International Space Station. A piece of bare metal in space under constant sunlight can get as hot as 260 degrees Celsius. This is dangerous to astronauts who have to work outside the station. If they need to handle bare metal, they wrap it in special coatings or blankets to protect themselves. And yet in the shade, an object will cool down to minus 100 degrees Celsius. Astronauts can experience vast differences in temperature between the side facing the sun and the side in shadow. Their spacesuits compensate using heaters and coolers.
But we didn't really test any of those materials for, is it space hardened or whatever, So it just has the same seats that like a normal car has. It's just literally a normal car in space. Which I kind of like the absurdity of that.
This is how hot it is in Italy. The car has melted. It's actually melted everything, the mirror, the lights, the indicators. Plastic off the side.
And even though those look very similar, those two boosters views, those are actually representing different boosters.
Landing burn has started.
Both boosters looking to be on track towards their respective landing zones.
Star boosters landing legs have started. Star boosters landing legs have deployed.
What was going through your mind? How amazed were you to see your roadster up there with Starman just cruising along with the Blue Planet? And how long will we be getting live views, do you think, from the car?
Well, I think it looks so ridiculous and impossible. And you can tell it's real because it looks so fake, honestly. We'd have way better CGI if it was fake. And the colors all look kind of weird in space.
The first lift off of the soundtrack right there. That's brand new era in space exploration. There's another look.
Uh-huh.
Real car.
So, I know, it's real car. And some people don't believe that image, but it is a real image. And some people don't believe that image, but it is a real image.
Show that. Here's the drama. That there is the central self. You can call it God, you can call it anything you like.
Looking for some.
and it's all of us. It's playing all the parts, all beings, whatsoever, everywhere, anywhere. And it's playing the game of hide and seek with itself. Get lost, gets involved in the farthest out adventures. But in the end, it always wakes up and comes back to itself. And when you're ready to wake up, you can wake up.
To SpaceX, we wish us the best today. And the reason you do this, everybody, the reason a society does this, there are two questions, Lauren, that we have all asked. Where did we come from? How did we all get here? Where did we come from? And are we alone in the universe? And if you want to answer those two questions, you have to explore space.
Wake up.
Imagine you're very confident that we were going to be visited by super intelligent aliens in, let's say, 10 years or 20 years at the most. Super intelligent.
So you think within 20 years,
yes,
we have alien and Earth? Do you think there is other intelligent life outside the Earth?
It seems probable. Maybe they're among us. I don't know. Some people think I'm an alien. Not true.
Do you think we'll make contact with alien within the next 50 years?
I mean, if there are super intelligent aliens out there, they're probably already observing us.
You're gonna wake up.
The battery's gonna last about 12 hours from launch, roughly. After that, it's just going to be out there in deep space for maybe millions or billions of years, who knows. Maybe discovered by some future alien race.
I think we're going to have strong indications of life beyond Earth within a decade. And I think we're going to have definitive evidence within 10, 20 to 30 years.